Welcome. My name is Blythe Kaufman, and I am the founder of the Children's Rosary Prayer Group Movement. Today, I would like to explain how to begin a Children's Rosary Prayer Group. The first step is to obtain permission from your pastor. It may be helpful to show him one of our Children's Rosary prayer books, which contains an imprimatur. This indicates that there is nothing included that is in opposition to the teachings of the Catholic Church. As this is a lay prayer group movement, it should be emphasized that beginning a children's rosary will not involve more work for our already very busy priests. Instead, this is a beautiful way for the children of the parish to come together in prayer, something that will bring fruits into the hearts of little ones, their families, and also the parish. The second step is to choose a location. Most of our children's rosary prayer groups meet in the church. Ideally, we encourage the children to meet kneeling before the altar. Some of our groups are able to meet during adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. This is a wonderful blessing. However, this may not always be possible in many cases. Some of our groups may meet in a parish center, chapel, or sometimes outside. We have children's rosary groups that also exist within schools and orphanages. The third step is to choose a meeting time. Most of our groups meet monthly or weekly. The decision of when to hold your meeting will depend in large part on the availability of the group leader, the schedule of the parish, and when families are available. Often the group will meet before a Mass, such as a Saturday Vigil Mass, or possibly before or after a Sunday morning Mass. If one decides to hold your group before Mass, I would recommend meeting 45 minutes before the Mass. In this way, there is ample time to hold the children's rosary and then clear all items from the altar for the preparation of the Mass. We have found that if one meets 30 minutes before Mass, there is a rushed feeling to the meeting. There are several benefits to meeting before Mass. One is that the children are not tired and families are already coming to Mass, and this involves not much more time to arrive early. Another advantage is that sometimes those adults coming to church early for Mass can enjoy being present for a children's rosary. And families can also see the children's rosary, which may draw more membership. A small disadvantage for holding it before Mass is that there is little opportunity usually for the children to socialize after the meeting. Just as adults find it comforting to talk to those in their prayer groups, children do as well. So it is nice to have a little time for the children to get to know the other children in the group. Groups that meet after Mass have the benefit of having the option to provide a small treat if desired. Providing before Mass usually is not possible. We do have some groups that meet after morning Mass on a Saturday, which has worked out very well. There are also groups that meet on a weekday during the evening. Sometimes meeting times have included 4:30 p.m., while other meetings would be at 6 or 6:30 p.m. There is a wide variety of times. If there is a large homeschool community in your area, a meeting time during the morning in the middle of the week may also work well. Overall, there is considerable flexibility and variability in choosing a meeting time. It's a good idea to pray about your meeting time as you discern when to meet. Once you pick your meeting time, it is very good to try to stay consistent with it. In this way, people can come to depend on that meeting time. Even if there's a week when attendance is low or you may find yourself alone, don't be discouraged. Instead, pick up your rosary and pray. There are many graces that come when we thirst for souls with our Lord. There will be struggles and questioning, but do not give up. You are doing something beautiful, and many graces will come. The fourth step is to invite a small group of families and children to your first children's rosary. You don't need a great number of families. Often two or three families will be perfect to begin your group. Once you begin your group, if you would like to try and grow your group, consider approaching a family after Mass and personally inviting the children. If the family seems interested, get their contact information, such as a phone number and an email. It is always a good idea to remind them a day or two before your meeting. Families are so busy these days, and reminders are always helpful. It is also a helpful thing to build a small email or contact list, so if there are special updates that you would like to share, you can do this as well. It's always good to include a notice in your church bulletin before your meetings. This often does not bring a great many people at first, but is a nice reminder once you have regular people attending. The fifth step is to register your group with the Children's Rosary. In this way, we can have a central list of all the Children's Rosary groups. We have several ways to register. This can be done by mail or preferably through our website.